Dear students, welcome to another video tutorial on data structure and algorithm. And today's topic is bubble sorting technique. So myself Niladri Shekhar Pal, I am working as an assistant professor at Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management at Computer Science and Engineering Department. The college is under JIS Group Educational Initiative and the college is situated at Baroipur. So let's start. So what is sorting technique? Sorting basically refers to the operation or technique of arranging and rearranging sets of data in some specific order. Okay. A collection of records called a list where every record has one or more fields. The fields which contain a unique value for each record is termed as the key field. Okay. And for example, a phone number directory can be thought of as a list where each record has three fields: name of the person, address of that person, and their phone numbers. Being unique, phone number can work as key to locate any record in the list. Sorting is the operation performed to arrange the records of a table or list in some order according to some specific ordering criteria. Okay. Sorting is performed according to some key value of each record. Okay. So what is sorting? Sorting basically refers to the operation or technique of arranging and rearranging set of data in some specific order. Okay. A collection of records called a list where every record has one or more fields. The fields which contains a unique value for each record is termed as the key field. Okay. For example, a phone number directory can be thought of as a list where each record has three fields: name of the person, address of that person, and their phone numbers. Okay. So being unique, phone number can work as a key to locate any record in the list. Okay. So sorting is the basically operation performed to arrange the records of a table, okay, or list in some order according to some specific order creation. Sorting is performed according to some key value of each record. The records are either sorted either numerically or alphanumerically. Okay. The records are then arranged in ascending or descending order depending on the numerical value of the key. Okay, so here is an example where the sorting list, a list of marks obtained by a student in any particular subject of the class. Okay, so basically there are two types of sorting. One is internal sorting and another one is external sorting. Okay, so basically there are two types of sorting. One is internal and another one is external. So what is internal sorting? If all the data that is to be sorted can be adjusted at a time in the main memory, the internal sorting method is being performed. Okay. So if all the data that is to be sorted can be adjusted at a time in the main memory, okay, then we can say that the internal sorting method is being performed. Okay. Now, what is external sorting? When the data that is to be sorted cannot be accommodated in the memory at the same time and some has to be kept in auxiliary memory such as hard disk, floppy disk or magnetic tapes, etc., then external methods are performed. Okay. So when the data that is to be sorted cannot be accommodated in the main memory at the same time, and some has to be kept in auxiliary memory, such as hard disk, floppy disk, garage band, magnetic tapes, etc. Then external sorting methods are performed. Okay? Now, what is the complexity of sorting? The complexity of sorting algorithm basically calculates the running time of a function in which n number of items are to be sorted. Okay? The choice for which sorting method is suitable for a problem depends on several dependency configurations for different problems. Okay? The most noteworthy of these considerations are the length of time spent by the programmer in programming a specific sorting program, the amount of machine time necessary for running the program, and the amount of memory necessary for running the program. Okay, so what is the complexity of sorting? Basically, the complexity of sorting algorithm calculates the running time of a function in which n number of items are to be sorted. Okay, so the choice for which sorting method is suitable for a problem depends on several dependency configurations for different problems. The most noteworthy of these considerations are the length of time spent by the programmer in programming specific sorting program, amount of machine time necessary for running the program, and the amount of memory necessary for running the program. Okay. Now, what is the efficiency of sorting? To get the amount of time required to sort an array of n elements by a particular method, the normal approach is to analyze the methods to find the number of comparisons required by it. Most of the sorting techniques are data sensitive, and so the metrics for them depends on the order in which they appear in an input array. Various sorting techniques are analyzed in various cases and named these cases as follows: best case, worst case, and average case. Okay. So these are the types of sorting. Okay. Bubble sort, selection sort, insertion sort, merge sort, quick sort, and heap sort. Okay, we will discuss these sorting techniques one by one. Okay. So now we'll discuss about bubble sort. Okay. Basically, bubble sort sometimes referred to as sinking sort. Okay. It is an example of sorting algorithm that repeatedly steps through the list, compares adjacent elements, and swaps them if they are in the wrong order. The pass through the list is repeated until the list is sorted. Okay. So it is basically the simplest sorting algorithm that works by repeatedly swapping the adjacent elements if they are in wrong order. Okay. So it is an algorithm that compares the adjacent elements and swaps their positions if they are not in the intended order. Okay. Bubble sort algorithm is used to arrange n number of elements, okay, in ascending order, and for that we have to begin with 0th element and compare it with the first element. Okay. So this sorting algorithm is comparison based algorithm, okay, in which each pair of adjacent elements is compared and the elements are swapped if they are not in order. Okay. If the 0th element is found greater than the first element, then the swapping operation will be performed. That is, the two values will get interchanged Okay, in this way, all the elements of the array get compared. Okay. Now, how bubble chart works? Suppose these are the list of elements. Okay. So, in the first iteration, we will compare 7 with 2. Okay, as you can see, we have compared 7 with 2. What is our objective? If the first element, that is this one, is greater than the next one, then there will be a swap. Otherwise, there is no change. Okay. So, as you can see, the first element is greater than the next one. So, there is a swapping. Okay. As you can see, we have swapped it. Okay. Next, there is a comparison between 7 and 6. And here is the same condition will be applied. Okay, as you can see that the first element is greater than the next one. Okay, so there is a swapping. Okay, so next we will compare with 7 and 5. Okay, so same condition here, 7 will be swapped. Okay, so as you can see that these 2, 6, 5, these are not in the final position, but 7 came to its final position. Okay, so what is our objective after iteration 1? So our objective was in iteration 1 was to find the highest number of element, that is, which is the maximum highest, okay, element, that is 7. So 7 has been identified and came to its final position. Okay, so after iteration 1 we get the maximum element, okay, that is 7. Next come to the iteration 2. In iteration 2 we will do the comparison on rest of the 3 elements. Okay, we will not touch 7. Why? Because 7 is already in its final position. Okay, so at first we will compare between 2 and 6. Okay, as there is no change. Okay, next we will compare with 6 and 5 and there will be a change. Okay, so as you can see that in this iteration 2, 6 has came to its final position. Okay, so after iteration 2, we get the second highest element. Okay, now come to the iteration 3. Okay, so in iteration 3, we will compare between 2 and 5. As you can see that 2 is smaller than 5, so there is no change. So 5 will came to its final position. Okay, so at iteration 3, 5, we will get our third highest element. Okay. So, side by side, we also get our fourth highest, as we do have only 4 elements. Okay. So, all the elements are in the its final position. Okay. And as you can see that the array of elements are already been sorted. Okay, so this is how the bubble chart works. Okay. Let's again do one thing. The total number of elements was 4. Okay, so how many iterations are there? Only 3 iterations are there. Okay. So if there are number of element is n, then total number of iteration will be n minus 1. Okay. Next, you can see that this is the first iteration. Okay, so how many comparisons are there? This is 1, 2 and 3. This is not a comparison. Okay, so there are 3 comparisons. So the number of elements is 4. This is iteration 1 and number of comparisons is 3. So as you can see that total number of comparison is total number of elements minus iteration number. That is 4 minus 1, total 3 comparisons. In the next iteration, you will get 4 minus 2, that is 2 comparisons. As you can see, only 2 comparisons. In the iterations 3, how many comparisons will be there? 4 minus 3, only 1 comparisons. Okay, so this is the logic. Okay, which will be required to do our C programming of bubble sorting. Okay, so hope you have understood how it will work. Okay, so now we'll write a C program. Okay, to find to implement bubble sort. Okay, so the logic is in the there are two loops basically. One is the outer loop, another one is inner loop. Outer loop means iterations, and inner loop means number of comparisons in each iteration. Okay, so if number of element is n, then total number of comparisons outer loop will be n minus 1. Okay, and if the total number of element is n, then it will be n minus 1 of the outer. Okay, so let's do the C program. So this is our C editor. Okay, we will go to the file, new source file. Okay, so at first we will take the header files, that is hash input stdio.h. okay, this is the standard input output. Next, kanaya.h. okay, this is console input output. Then int main. Okay, main is the basically the main function. Any C program must contains a main function. Okay, because C program will start executing from this main function. Okay, so within this main function we will take or we will run our C programs. Okay, so now we'll taking the variables. This is the array. N, this is 5 and this is 10. Okay, these are the variables we require. Next, printf. Printf is basically a function called library function. It is used to print something. Okay, so printf is basically defined within the stdio.h header file, standard input output header. To enter number of elements. So scan it. Percentage D, comma and percent N. Okay. We think how many elements will be in the array, okay, that we have taken. Next we will take the elements of the array. Okay, so printf slash a, enter the elements of the array. So for I equals to 1. Okay, I less than equals to n, I plus plus. Okay, printf enter the enter the percent d element. Okay, enter the percent d element. is why the article will be printed. Next scanner. Percentage D, comma, person ARRI. Okay. So this is how we will take the values in the array. Okay. Now we'll do the sorting. Okay. So as I have told that there are basically two parts, the two loop. One is the outer loop and then another was inner loop. Okay. In the outer loop, what we will do? In the outer loop, we will take n minus up to n minus 1. Okay. So the for loop for I equals to 1, I less than equals to n minus 1, I plus plus. Okay. And within each loop, there will be a j loop. Okay. So there will be minimum one comparison, and it will run maximum n minus I. Okay. J plus plus. Okay. Why n minus I? Because as you can see that in case of iteration 1, okay, when the total number of element was 4, total comparisons was 4 minus 1, that is 3. Okay, 4 is the number of elements and 1 was the iteration number. Okay. Okay. So within that there will be a comparison. If ARR J, if the previous one is greater than, okay, the next one, then there is a question of comparison. Okay, then temp will be ARRJ okay, or we can say that we just take the value of ARRJ and keep it at within the temp. Okay. So the new ARRJ is ARRJ plus 1. Okay. And after that we can write that ARR. J plus 1 as 10. Okay. So temp is ARRJ. If the value of suppose, I'm just writing here. Suppose this is like this. Okay. So 7 is ARRJ. And 5 is ARRJ plus 1. Okay. So temp is now 7. Okay. Next ARRJ equals to ARRJ plus 1. So ARRJ is now 5. Okay. And after that ARRJ will be 7. Okay. So this is how it will work. Okay. So in these lines, okay, in this portion, we have completed the sorting part. Okay, and after the sorting part you will print this, the sorted list. Okay, so printf slash n sorted is okay. So there will be another again a for loop for I equals to 1, I less than equals to m, I plus plus. Okay. So printf slash n percentage d, comma arr I. Okay. So this was the code of bubble sorting. Okay. So let's first save the program, then run it, and then we will again discuss for a second. Okay. So this is the desktop. This is bubble.c. Okay. So let's execute it. Sorry, I have not taken J, I think. Okay. Execute it. So first 5 elements are here. 2, 4, 1, 6, 3. As you can see that this has been shorted. Okay, so let's discuss the program once again. Okay, so these are the basically variables. These are the entire number of elements, that is how many elements will be there in the array. Okay, this is ampersand and scanf. Okay, the value. Okay. Then we have taken the elements in the array using this for loop. Okay. And after that, this is the main logic part. Okay. This is basically the sorting part. Okay. So what we have did, as you know, we have two loops. One is outer loop and another one is inner loop. In the outer loop means how many iterations will be there. As you know, if the number of element is n, then there will be n minus 1. Okay, so the iteration will start from 1 and will continue up to n minus 1, and in each iteration there will be n minus I number of comparisons. Okay, that is why j loop will continue for n minus 1 time. Okay, and in within this loop there will, if there is a condition that the previous element is greater than the next one, then there will be a swapping. Okay, so what that we have done here. Okay, if arr j is greater than, okay, then there is a compare, then there is a, what I want to say, that swapping. Okay, so for swapping we have used a third variable, that is m. Okay. After that, we have printed. Okay, the array. Okay, so student, this was the program of bubble sorting. Okay, so this was the program of bubble sorting. Hope you have understood. Okay, so if you have any doubt, any query, you can write on the comment section. If you have liked my video, you can subscribe to my channel. Okay. And you can visit www.facebook.com/digitalclassroom and like my page. So student, thank you for now. See you in the next video tutorial. Thank you.